This week on Storyboard, Varun Berry, Managing Director, Britannia Industries, sheds light on the food major's sustainability strategy based on four pillars: growth, resources, people and governance. And we have Naveen Khemka, CEO South Asia at Mediacom, speaking about big trends in advertising and marketing that will define 2022. Hello and welcome to Storyboard. This is Shibani Gharat. The pandemic has truly intensified the need for more businesses to act and accelerate efforts on sustainability front. Besides doing good for people and the planet, it's also good for the bottom lines and brands. In an exclusive interview with Storyboard 18's Dilshad Irani, Varun Berry, Managing Director, Britannia Industries, sheds light on the food major's sustainability strategy that's based on four pillars: growth, resources, people and governance. The challenges to meeting its goals and the communication conundrum.
Hello, Varun, and welcome to Storyboard 18. Absolutely delighted to speak with you.
Hello, how are you, Dilshad?
Very well, very well. Varun, the past couple of years have been absolutely extraordinary. Life just changed on a dime. And that, of course, has prompted a lot of us, individuals, people, companies, businesses, to reassess, rethink priorities. And one of the key areas of focus and concern and importance, of course, has been sustainability. Now, it's an important piece for any responsible organization, but I want to get a sense from you on what sustainability means for Britannia and you in the current context. Let's begin with that.
We've got a very clear a framework that we look at for sustainability. We look at a framework where it covers growth, governance, resource, and people, right? So that's the framework that we look at. Now, sustainability has been very important for us for a very, very long time, but we haven't put it in a framework. We haven't really made it, we haven't published a report on sustainability till now. But we've been working very, very hard for many, many years on these parameters, right? And if you were to look at it, sustainability is a driver of competitive advantage for most companies. It definitely opens up new areas of growth. It improves operational efficiency, which it has for us in the past and continues to do so even today. And it strengthens the internal and external relationships of our organization and our people, right? However, the problem with sustainability is that you've got to get it, very well set within the organization. Otherwise, it becomes a bit of a challenge, right? And the challenges are as follows, right? So what are the challenges that one faces? First is that we have to ensure that there is coherence in what we are going to do as far as sustainability is concerned. So there has to be a long-term sustainability matrices which are defined versus, you have your short-term KPIs that you work on in any case, the performance indicators for all of us. So the balance between the long and short is certainly one challenge. The other is that it has to be culturally very, very well ingrained into the organization so that everyone believes in it. Everyone wants to perform on the sustainability indexes. And third challenge is that it's a very dynamic area, right? It's dynamic because there are things which are changing. The requirements from the government are changing. So we have to keep on top of what is the latest on sustainability.
Again, from a sort of a large corporation view, how have you seen, even from your personal experience running a large company like Britannia, how have you seen the connections between, the view on connections between bottom lines and the sustainability agenda change over time?
No, so as I was telling you, sustainability is clearly, if you look at it, sustainability will give you cost efficiencies as well, right? If you follow them to a T, it's not just about working towards the betterment of the world, But in the long term, it will give you benefits from, to the bottom line as well, right? So just to highlight the renewable energy agenda that we have, right? It's given us great benefits on the bottom line as well, right? Because one, we've gone to renewable energy. Second, we've got some cost efficiencies for our businesses, but it takes time. It means investments to be made, and thereafter it takes time for them to be stabilized. But in the long term, it will give it to you. So that's why I was saying the balance between the long term and the short term is very important.
We've seen, of course, in the past decade, the rise of purpose-driven brands. And all of that, of course, reflects in the communication, marketing communication also. Tell me, what's your take on how challenging or what opportunities are there in sort of taking your sustainability agenda and presenting it to the consumer, in your marketing communications, and how that impacts the brand then? What's your general sense of how that works and how that has worked for Britannia?
See, we have a challenge on that front. And the challenge really is that we are in a part of food which is the cheapest form of food, right? So if you were to look at the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, right, we are at the lowest level. We are the bhook pyaas kind of level, right? So if you think about biscuits is 100 rupees, less than 100 rupees a kilo, right? The glucose biscuits are as low as 80 rupees a kilo. So it's important for us to, one, balance, between cost, taste and quality, because it's not a superficial, just on the edges kind of a category either, right? People consume biscuits through the day. People consume biscuits not just at one income level, but across. So that's one challenge for us. And hence, we haven't been front and center of, communicating that we are organic and we are gluten-free and we are, vegan and we are... So we haven't been able to do that. But it's a matter of time. The fact that we do renewable energy, the fact that we are taking out plastics, we don't think that we need to communicate this. I think those are things which we are doing because we believe in it. We think it's right for the environment. We believe it's right for the world. And we would not like to communicate that as something that, because that's something that we had gone wrong on. We are correcting that as we move forward.
2 years of the pandemic, it feels like forever. What's your outlook on 2022? What are your areas of concern? What are the key opportunities that you're seeing and the big trends that you're focusing on as a company?
Well, I would say cautiously optimistic about the growth prospects in 22. Clearly, the economic activity is on a recovery path. The GDP growth of 8.4% in July, September is, while it's on a low base, but, the number is a robust number. The private consumptions becoming better, on the go consumption, people are traveling, you see a lot more traffic than what you've seen, etc. So all that, so consumption is improving for FMCG, especially food companies, etc. The challenge really is the inflationary trends. The inflationary winds have been very strong. We've seen inflation in every raw material that we use, and more so in oil. We do need to mitigate this as we go forward. Otherwise, while the revenue growth will happen, it'll certainly impact volume growth. But I do think that the country has done what was necessary. The vaccination drive has been going well. However, new strains are looming large, but hopefully that will also be in the past. So let's see. Let's hope for the best. We are obviously focusing on. We've not had that kind of constraint as far as our products are concerned. concerned, we've seen decent growths in the last 2 years as well. And we are continuing to focus on improving our penetration down the pop strata. We're looking at expansion plans. We're looking at new capacities. We're putting up a plant in Tamil Nadu, one in UP, expanding our plant in Ranjangaon. So we are continuing with our activity as far as growths are concerned.
Great. Thank you. Thank you so much for your time, Varun. It's lovely chatting with you.
Thanks a lot. Great chatting with you as well.
It is time for us to take a short break. On the other side, we have Naveen Khemka, CEO South Asia at Mediacom, speaking about big trends in advertising and marketing that will define 2022.